You're going to be going in North Hall. That's where they locked you up for all the big crime. They called us the two percenters. A man by the name of Connecticut, Don Williamson, and I together, he was in the old dining hall. We attempted escape there. They got us. They took us and brought us over here for attempted escape. And then we cut our walls out. We had two pieces of blade. And anyway, cut through the wall, dug underneath the floor, 37 feet to the outside. As you see in cell 20 on A side, okay, cell 20, you'll see there's been a knife cut out of the bunk, top bunk, about that far. That's what we dug the tunnel with. We had a Bakelite cereal bowl, and that's what we basically dug the dirt. But we made a sled out of our mattress, and it, of course, took the batting out of it, made the dummies. We took the and sewed it to form of our bodies with a homemade needle, and then the threads out of the coveralls. But anyway, we made a sled out of the mattress cover. They're the fire retardant type, and we'd roll magazines in and around it with strings, so it had a little bit of size. One end of it had a little rope that we about the size of my little finger, but on the other side had a bigger rope. And so I would dig the tunnel, and Kinetic would pull the dirt out with the big rope. I'd pull an empty sled, so there wasn't any running back and forth. And 84 days from the day we were locked up for attempted escape, we actually escaped. We were the only ones that ever escaped our max. And so it looked like when we actually found us, caught us, and they found where we got out, it looked like we went down in the ground and under and up. But we didn't. We actually, behind my cell, we dropped down and we dug the tunnel 22 feet. We dropped down, I forget how many feet, and under 7 feet and back up. corner is where I escaped in 1979 the maximum security. In a 37-foot tunnel they filled with concrete.
Subscribe.